Hi everyone, my name is Nuno from Imaginando and today I'm here to show you what's new about LK. LK has been the first application from Imaginando. Just before being LK, it was called Live Control, and it was a long road until we get to the point we are here today. Until the last version, you could only use the matrix module in live mode. But now you can also use it as a MIDI mode. And what can you do with this module in MIDI mode? Well, the cool thing is that you can sequence another other gear or software using LK. So how do you do that? First, you need to use this icon, which is a new icon, which shows the MIDI inputs and the MIDI outputs. MIDI inputs on the top, MIDI outputs on the bottom. Then you can create tracks by clicking Shift and pressing plus, and you can create rows by pressing Shift and this plus sign over here. So now I have a matrix of four clips. Let's do something with clip one, okay. Double tap, I create a new clip, and now I pull this over, and I have here a keyboard, a piano roll. But how do I send MIDI to my machines? Well, you need a few other things to get started. First, you will need a lightning adapter. In iOS case, if you are using Android, you will need a USB ODG cable adapter. Then you will need a USB hub. I have a USB powered hub that I've bought on Thomann. And why is it important to be USB powered? Because you will not be able to drain the energy from your mobile device. It will pop up a warning saying that it doesn't have enough energy, or that the device is consuming too much energy, so it will be shut down. This ensures that you can plug as many devices as you want. In this case, this hub has 7 ports, and I'm powering the USB to MIDI adapter and the Roland TR-08 that I have here connected as well. So this is a really nice investment, a USB powered hub. To connect it to the USB powered hub, I have this device, which is a Roland USB MIDI interface. It's called UM1. There are cheaper devices on the market, but this was one of the very first devices I have bought to do the testing over here. And final, but not the least, we have a MIDI through device. With this device, you can use a single MIDI output to route MIDI to several devices using different channels. So with this device, I can send MIDI to up to 4 different devices with a single MIDI output. There are devices with more ports, you just need to Google around. So now that I've shown you what kind of devices do you need to do this, let me show you how to configure LK in order to send MIDI to your devices. First, you need to select the MIDI out port. So let's go to the channel one and select the MIDI out UM1. You can see that the MIDI device is connected by opening the menu and pressing the MIDI section. You will see the MIDI inputs and the MIDI outputs listed here. You can also enable them or disable them by just toggling them on the menu. If you are not interested in receiving MIDI or sending MIDI throughout these ports, you just need to toggle them here in the menu. Let's now select UM1 for both tracks. So basically what I'm doing is I will send MIDI from track one to Behringer Model D that I have here in my front. And I will send MIDI from the second track to the Roland TR-08 to channel two, and I select here the channel. So output device UM1, output channel one. Track two, output device UM1, output channel two. So now I can open the MIDI composer here, and I'm already sending MIDI to the Behringer Model D. As you can see here, the light indicator shows that MIDI is being sent out. The same is true for the TR-08. So as you can see, the MIDI is going through the same device, but through different channels, and then they are routed with the MIDI through device. We could already start a beat. Okay, let's close this panel. And now I could select this clip and start. Leave this song composing demonstrations to Lucas and then to a next video. I'm just going to show you what we have done with the clip composer as well. We have rewrite the clip composer interaction to be completely used by touch only. So in the previous versions, you would need to select between a pencil and the selection mode in order to use the clip composer. Right now, you don't need to switch between tools because we have based the interaction only on touch. If you want to create notes, you just need to tap the clip and create a note. If you want to delete, just tap the same note. Very easy. If you want to select notes, you just start the selection mark from any point and go through the notes you want to select. If you want to select a note and move it, so we have just selected two notes and now we move them, okay? Very easy. If you want to delete more than one note at the same time, we just tap on the top of selected notes. Cool, easy. And to make a note bigger, you just need to grab the tail and push it. Very easy as well. If you want to change the velocity, you just go down here and change it. So this is the very same principle from the previous version. If you want to select a pitch in order to go through the velocity bars, you just need to go through the keyboard and select the pitch you want. So right here I have the velocity for this note and this note over here, and if I select this note, I have the velocity bar over here. So also we have added our own undo engine, so I've just need to click here and go back. So if you are on clip composer only right now, you can have undo and redo, because we have a redo here as well. Okay. And finally, if you want to save a project, you just need to press this disk icon over here and select a new name for the project. Oops. Okay. Okay, cool. So now if I get out of LK and start LK again, I just need to load my new project, and it's here. Cool, isn't it? So this is what's new about LK 1.5.1. We are still improving LK. We are very proud in this app, and your feedback also supports us in making it better through the time. So I hope you have enjoyed this brief tutorial of the new capabilities of LK, and we are looking forward to have your feedback about it. And if you have any questions, just go to our website or reply to the video in the comments. We are here to answer your questions. Thanks for watching, and if you like our channel, subscribe and give us a like. We will see you in the next video, probably with Lucas showing you how to use LK to make music. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.